Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I've got another movie character inspired glam look. Like a movie character turning to a glam look. Yeah. Obviously it's an Avengers thing because I've recently been rewatching all the movies, and also I saw this sweater online and I wanted it, and here we are. This one is inspired by Thor, and I gotta admit that I didn't have a plan to begin with, so that probably didn't help. But it ended up as more of a color inspired look than actually a character inspired look, admittedly, but I do really like how the look turned out. Without further ado, let's get on to it. Okay, obviously my eyebrows are already done. I'm going to immediately move on to the eyelids, and I'm going to start with a white primer this time around because I want to use bold colors and I want to use red, and I don't want to have my usual issue of red always goes pink or purple on me. So a white base is just the safest way to go. The one I'm using is by NYX, and as always I'll list everything I've used below the video, but as always do just take it as a suggestion and not like a rule, like you don't need to use the exact same products I did to get this look. Actually, in fact, it will probably even be easier if you don't use a base like I am using that's like very old and nearly dried out. I really need to buy a new one. Now, I'm starting off by creating the beginning of a cut crease. I think I'm going to make it a half cut crease because I already did a full cut crease for the Iron Man inspired look for members. I'm going to start it off with red. At first I was like I could do a Thunder inspired look, but then I realized one, I had already done a Thunder inspired look ages ago, inspired just by Thunder. And also, I didn't want to like go the obvious way and do the whole Thunder thing for Thor. I just wanted to do something different, so I decided to go for more of, you know, something inspired by his outfit with the red and the metal of the harness and stuff. So yeah, that's basically the idea. Anyway, I'm just building up the color, one thing is to make it high enough in the inner corner to really, you know, still have space to do the inner corner cut crease later on. I just want to do an inner corner cut crease, and also make sure it is high enough overall that we can still apply black at the exact deepest point of the cut crease without covering all of the red, because that would not be, you know, good. Now, this is what we're going to go for next, and the keyword here is blending and being careful, and being careful is not a keyword. Anyway, I'm going to use a pointy brush, a very sharp pencil brush first. That's not supposed to have a random piece of fabric on it. And really just map out the cut crease even more with a black eyeshadow. For anyone wondering, I'm using the Conspiracy Palette by Jeffree Star and Shane Dawson because I wanted something with very good pigment. Just because it's easier if you don't have to go over everything 5 times. It's doable, but like if you have something with very good pigment, I advise you to use that. I'm just making a line here. And the good thing about this brush is you can be very precise with it. But then once you press it a little bit harder and keep it a little bit more flat, you can also start blending with it, which is kind of nice. So yeah, I'm just building up this color until it's like nice and dark. And then once I've reached a point where I can't get further with that brush, I'm just switching over to the blender I just used for the red shade. Grabbing a little bit of the black shade for the outer corner and then just blending it inwards. Wiping off the brush so I don't apply too much black. And then start blending it. And really I don't want this to be like completely like blackest black ever. I just want it to be darker, so yeah, I mostly just want everything to also noticeably be red, like that's really the color we're going for the crease. So I'm just going over it with red again, and just again blending. Just keep blending until it's finally all smooth. Then I'm just going to do a brow bone highlight in a very pale matte nude shade, just in this outer corner and this inner corner here, because that's literally the only part where we can still apply a brow bone highlight at this point. And we're going to finally then blend it out with the large fluffy blender, because no tutorial without the large fluffy blender. It's literally my most used brush. But anyway, I'm just going to go over like the entirety of the crease we just done. Just to make sure that there's no harsh lines and no weird spots. Now, just going on to the next part now. Also, by the way, I just figured out what exactly I want. Halfway through the tutorial, that's how I work. But anyway, first off, I'm going to focus on the top lid and then specifically the inner corner cut crease. I'm just using my completely doomed and decaying, and this is supposed to have another piece of plastic on top of it, but it broke off. Glitter glue by NYX. I completely destroyed the packaging, but yeah, I'm just using a flat brush that gives a lot of control so I can make a nice sharp edge in the inner corner here. And now finally, 12 hours later, we can actually move on to the silver, which is going to be the cut crease color. And due to the fact that I use not a normal primer but a glitter primer, the metallic is really, really going to pop. Now I'm going to do something that I don't often do. I'm actually going to use a nude eye primer. I didn't mean to smear that on my thumb. Oops. And just apply that below my eye. Because I want to do something quite dark there too. And I don't want to risk doing that all the way at the end and then getting fallout and ruining my base. Because that would be tragic. So I'm just basically applying it right below my eye and I'm blending it downwards so that I don't get a weird transition line when I finally do get to concealer. Now we're going to go for a below the eye wing, which literally has nothing to do with the actual like movie or character or whatever. This is just basically inspired by the colors and I just wanted to do something that I haven't really done before. If I've done it below the eye wing before, then it wasn't very memorable because I don't remember, so yeah. But I'm using a flat brush and pretty much a metallic shade of eyeshadow that sort of looks like the color of his harness in like the first Thor movie. The metal parts, obviously. So yeah, that's basically the inspiration. I'm really just drawing a wing there. A thin one. And just blending it below the lashes. And then with a slightly paler metallic shade, I'm going to blend that on a fluffy blender. Like the bottom part of me. And pulling weird faces with that really helps really stretch the skin so it goes nice and tight. I mean, you're gonna look ridiculous, but the end result of the eyeshadow is going to be a lot better than if you wouldn't do it. Then I'm just gonna add eyeliner and basically I'm just going right above where the smoky wing is so that hopefully it's gonna look like the wing sort of has a shadow. Okay, luckily that only took about 15 years. Now I'm just applying a white pencil to the waterline to brighten it up there. And now that we're basically doing everything before foundation and all, I'm also going to do my inner corner highlight with a shimmery white shade. I want it to be really, really bright to still have some of that like lightning effect in there. I don't know, lightning, bright, pale, shimmery color. It fits in my mind, so that's what we're gonna do. Now, before I'm gonna move on to eyelashes and mascara and stuff like that, I am going to do my face base real quick off camera. Because otherwise, you know, translucent powder might get on them and it makes them paler and it annoys me. So be right back. Okay, I gotta admit, I'm not used to seeing myself like this anymore. I don't know, like lately I've really been into more natural finish sort of things and now it's more like for the face, I mean. Basically I have a lot going on right now. Basically a lot of foundation, then I highlighted with very pale concealer beneath my eyes and on the bridge of my nose and on my chin. I also did a cream contour and then I applied a heap of powder, like heaps and heaps of powder. And here we are. So yeah, from this point onwards I just realized, by the way, that I completely forgot the finished part of the eye look. That's so clumsy. I'm just going to apply a little bit of the paler metallic shade that I blended the bottom eyelid out with. and apply it right here where I completely forgot to cover the white eyeshadow base. But anyway, about the face, I'm just going to still show you the colors that I'm going to use. So I'm going to start off with a slightly shimmery bronzer. Nothing too shimmery because I've got oily skin, but I do want a little bit more warmth there. And then my usual peachy blush that fits with anything, including this. And then finally highlight. I'm not pulling it onto the eyebrow or like below the eyebrow like I usually would because I don't want to cover the eyeshadows there. And then before finish with the eyes, I'm just going to do setting spray to set this entire thing. Then falsies, I'm going for a pair, you can't really tell, but anyway, but it's not very long because I don't want it to be too cute. But I do want it to be, you know, I do want to like make the wings stand out a little bit more, so these are very fanned out. As you can tell, this eye, not too much effect, but still some. Okay, that's on there. Then for the bottom lashes, I'm just going to use Vertige Mascara by Isochet, which pretty much has a stick instead of a wand. And it kind of makes the bottom lashes a bit spiky, which is what I'm going for. And by now the eyelash glue will be dry enough that I can also safely apply mascara on the top lashes. And this time I am applying a little bit more than usual, because I want them to be a little bit thicker. Especially on the outer corners. And then, finally, the moment I thought would never come. The lips. The final thing. I'm just going to do them nude. Okay, I'll be honest with you. I didn't mean to overline my lips this much. This is Celebrity Skin by Jeffree Star Cosmetics, and for some reason, every time I use this liquid lipstick, I look like I've had lip fillers done. I kind of like it, but it's never on purpose. But anyway, that is actually the end of the tutorial, so let's go on to the show part. And here we are with the final results. So yeah, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my tutorials, you can always subscribe to my channel. For now, as always, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!